In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi, it is this muscle. This is very, very wide and big muscle. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let's talk about origin. Origin of latissimus dorsi is very, very wide. It attaches on this level, okay? That's T7 through T12. T7 through T12, okay? But this area, you know, T7 through T12. And it also attaches on rib cage. That's rib 9, 10, 11, 12. 9, 10, 11, 12. So it is about this area, okay? Rib 9, let's say R, rib 9 through rib 12, okay? T7 through T12, rib 9 through rib 12. It also attaches on scapula, just tiny bit. This is inferior angle, right? Inferior angle of scapula, about this area. Okay, next one is this area of pelvis. This is iliac crest. Iliac crest, it's about this area. Okay, let's go to next one. I said it attaches on thoracic spine. What about this area? This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. That is very wide fascia on backside of body. Okay. So latissimus dorsi has many, many origin. T7 through T12. This area. Rib 9 through rib 12, about this area. Inferior angle of scapula, iliac crest, and thoracolumbar fascia. Look at that. That has so many attachments. Especially, latissimus dorsi is only muscle that originates from pelvis. Then it attaches on humerus. What does it mean? That means it's from pelvis, lower extremity, to upper extremity. This is the only muscle. Now let's look at insertion. Insertion is this part. This part is called intertubercular groove. Intertubercular groove. It's on anterior part of humerus. Yes, it is on anterior part. Please remember that. Because origin is on backside. Okay. Now insertion is front part. What does it mean? Then let me go to function of latissimus dorsi. Main function of latissimus dorsi is shoulder extension. Extension. This is very powerful shoulder extensor. Okay, shoulder extension and adduction. Adduction is when you close arm this way. Okay, extension and adduction. Now, do you remember I said origin is on back part and insertion is front part. So it's like, you know, curving like that from backside and it ends up at front part. So this kind of spiral movement makes internal rotation of shoulder. Internal rotation. If latissimus dorsi attached on backside, that would make external rotation. However, think about its direction. It's on anterior part. Now, if muscle pulls bone this way, that makes internal rotation. This is very, very unique muscle. Extension, adduction, and internal rotation. By the way, there is one muscle whose function is very similar to latissimus dorsi. What is it? That is teres major. Teres major. Its function is same as latissimus dorsi. Extension, adduction, and internal rotation. Okay, this is very, very unique thing. So, in this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of latissimus dorsi. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.